here is an all-star superstar athlete. He plays football and he also runs track. So basically, we can use the SFMA or the Selective Functional Movement Assessment tool on him to figure out exactly where he has any kind of pain or problematic areas. And it is a great diagnostic tool. Basically, it helps you to figure out exactly what the cause of the pain is. Therefore, you can find the source of the pain, because sometimes they're not always the same exact thing, which helps you have a better treatment plan and effectively shorten like your treatment time. All right, so let's get started. So basically, Jalen is gonna have his feet together at all times throughout the entire test. So what are you gonna do, Jalen, for me? You're gonna try to touch your chin down to your chest without opening your lips. Okay, ready?
Okay.
And as much as you can. And come back up. Try that one more time. Okay, so Jalen, is that painful?
No.
Okay, so for him, that would be dysfunctional but non-painful. As you can see, Jalen could not touch his chin down to his chest. All right, next, try to look up at the ceiling as much as you can for me, Jalen. Very good, and then look back up again. Try that again. Okay, so here, once again, Jalen's face should be about 10 degrees off from the horizon, and it's not, so look up again. So Jalen would be another dysfunctional, actually, is it painful, Jalen? No, another dysfunctional, not painful. Perfect. So now we're gonna try to have you look over to your right shoulder. So ready? Back to the center. Try that one more time for me. Here what we're looking for is that his chin goes over the midline of his collarbone, which it does, so that's great. Any pain with that? Perfect. So that's a functional and non-painful. Let's try the other side. Good. Look straight again. Try the other side again. Or the same side, yeah. Good. And look straight. Was that painful? Okay. So even though that wasn't painful, this actually was dysfunctional for Jalen. He was lifting his chest up, his shoulder up, just to try to reach it there a little bit, but that's okay. All right, so the next motion that I'm gonna have you do, Jalen, is you're gonna try to touch down and touch your toes. So arms together, reach down and touch your toes for me as much as you can. Lovely, come back up. Any pain with that?
No, just a stretch.
Just a stretch, try that again one more time. Okay, and Jalen right now shows a nice, beautiful curve, so that's perfect. And typically you'd want to take a look at his sacrum to make sure that there's about an 80 degree angle. So if I have my calendar, I tell you, but right now Jalen looks to be pretty good with that. Come back up, Jalen. Awesome. So now both arms are gonna go up and you're gonna look up at the ceiling for me, and now you're gonna bend backwards as much as you can. Again, here you're looking to make sure that Jalen is not having any excessive effort to do this. Also that his shoulder blade is going down by the heels. And come back up, Jalen. He's struggling a little bit there. All right. There's only three more. You can do this. So what you're going to do is you're going to turn your entire body to the right for me. And back to the center. Let's try that again, but this time keep your arms down and just turn completely to the right. Beautiful. Any pain with that, Jalen? Nice. And then come back to the center. So again, another dysfunctional normal, because his shoulders should actually, you should be able to see them. They should be in line. So he'd be about 50 degrees. Let's turn to the left. That's even tighter. Does that feel tighter to you? Yeah, it's a little tighter, right? Okay, come back to the center. But is that painful though?
No.
No, so dysfunctional, non-painful. Perfect. All right, so the last one that you're gonna do, Jalen, is you're gonna do a squat for me, but you're gonna stay in that same position. I want you to try to squat as low as you can, and then I'll give you another cue, ready? Actually, hands out in front of you. Beautiful, and down. Come back up. Try that one more time for me. Any pain? And as you can see, Jalen is unable to clear the horizon, like horizontal. If he was able to, I would ask him to then bring his hands down and make a fist by his feet, and then take a look and see if he's able to hold that position and come back up, Jalen. So with that, you can bring your arms down. With that, we know the specific areas where Jalen was A, dysfunctional in his movement patterns, and also where he was painful or non-painful, which can help us know exactly how to guide the treatment. So as you can see, even though I use the test for Jalen who's coming in for an ankle injury, it can be used for anybody, to be honest. So if you're coming in with a cervical or a neck issue, going all the way down to an ankle issue, we can use a test basically to help guide us to figure out exactly where to start. So shoulder, neck, hip, it doesn't really matter where, we know really what the root cause of the pain is and figure out, you know, where to go. Alright, so in conclusion, after we've done the test, we found out that Jalen had a few patterns that were both dysfunctional and non-painful. So what you would want to do is, especially since Jalen is coming in for an ankle injury, you want to start from the bottom up, right? So his squat was pretty dysfunctional, but it was non-painful, so you can start there, figure out, or you can break down the squat and see what components of the squat is causing him to have the movement pattern be dysfunctional, and then take it from there.